the ring just got tighter. A lot tighter. Bloody ring. It's loose. Get off me and stay off. The ring just got tighter. A lot tighter. Bloody ring. It's loose. Get off me and stay off. Thank you. It's been cursed. It's been cursed. It's been cursed. It's been cursed. Ah, the armor set is complete.
Thank you. Look out. I see a trap nearby.
Metallic squeal. A one-armed skeleton clad in a pristine coat unfolds himself from inside the chest. He rolls his neck, aligning spine and skull in a long, crackling chorus.
Speak. Captain Sexzapper, slaver of the seas, servant of the Source King. Thank you for your help, do I? Now, I'll thank you for your life.
Sapor tilts his head. The vertebrae in his neck bulge unpleasantly while he thinks your words over.
Agreed. Worthless without its like is that coat. I hope no ill-intended collector should find you. Cut it right off your back. For your sake, may we never meet again.
Thank you.
The skull crumbled to bits. Look out. I see a trap nearby. Another skull crumbled to bits. Frozen ground in the middle of a swamp. What's going on? A winter dragon. Is it doing, Chick?
The dragon stares you down with flinty, intelligent eyes. He tries to speak, but his jaw is bound tightly by the same thick chains that shackled him to the pillars. Unreadable glyphs mantle this. Unreadable glyphs mantle. Knock you back. The freed dragon looks sick and pale. As you approach, he stretches his tattered wings weakly and fixes his intense gaze upon you. Frozen tears glint in his eyes.
My gratitude for your efforts, friend. Yet I am no more free now than I was in those chains. Please. Help me find true liberty, or sing me to the endless slumber. But of course, that must be why you stand before me. Slain cold to the Lord of Death, and here you are. A coincidence. Ah. My fate, it seems, is not my own to call. My soul is bound to joyless obedience. Purged of my source by the wickedest of witches. I stand enthralled to her every whim. She has only to command, and my traitorous body complies. The witch Radeka. I was in love with her once. For the smallest slight, really a trifle, she wielded a purging wand against me, enslaving me to her will. Now only my voice remains my own. Allow? I did not choose this. As I am quite sure, you did not choose any number of indignities in your own life. Least of all, your presence on this hellish isle. She trekked far underground beneath a nearby tower, seeking ingredients for her vile potions. I can feel her dark heart beating within my own, even from here. I await her return, yet I would prefer to welcome death in the sight of her face again.
The dragon sniffs and rakes at the ground with one razor-sharp talon.
A thought cannot mend a soul. A prayer cannot heal what has been ruined. You talk to soothe yourself, not me. That you would even ask such a question of a stranger already in your debt. There is much goodness within you, but this task would not be easy. Radeka is a canny one, cat to your mouse. She consumed all my source with her purging wand. So long as she holds it, she has absolute control over me. If you could retrieve it for me, I could be free again.
Retreat from me! I may have lost my source, but I can still best a puny human.
Even without my source, I will still overpower you.
Frozen ground in the middle of a swamp. What's going on? A winter dragon. What on earth is it doing chained up here?
The dragon rakes the earth, cracks the walls, quakes from the impact. The freed dragon looks.
My granted, but of course, that must be why. My soul is bound to jewel. The witch Radeka! I allow. I did not choose. She tricked Fagin for
the dragon.
A thought cannot mend that you would even ask. She consumed all my source with her purging. You would have my gratitude. And whatever aid I can then. Was the freedom you promised merely another cruel joke of your kind? Thank you.
to meet you. How's your day been? Oh, it's been quite a day. One moment, my flesh was flaming with cursed fire. The next, a stranger came along and eased my pain. Now I'm just trying to get used to life as a pig. It's not so easy. I never did enjoy truffles. Well, I can trace it all back to Bracchus Rex, of course. Many of us opposed his reign. Few dared to speak against him, though. A few of us wizards took the chance, though. We figured if we spread the word of his deeds, we might encourage enough people to come together, find a way to take him down. But we underestimated the cowardice of our comrades. All we succeeded in doing was being branded heretics and brought to Bracchus Rex's court. The results were horrifying. A double curse, turned into pigs and set aflame for eternity. I like not being on fire, so I don't want to complain too much about the pig part. I'm not sure. I have prayed to Armadia, but she offers no answers. Really? There must be a shrine there. If anyone can restore me to my previous wizardly self, it's Armadia. I'm so grateful for this news. I'm going there now to seek Armadia's blessing. Thank you. Thank you.
Kerbin stares at the body of his dead comrade, tightly gripping his weapon in a cold fury.
We'll find them, or we'll find another way.
You would attack the Magisters directly. Are you so eager to die, Seeker? You cannot stand against the Shriekers, not without stronger weapons than these.
We'll find them, or we'll find another way.
You would attack the Magisters directly. Are you so eager to die, Seeker? You cannot stand against the Shriekers, not without stronger weapons than these.
We'll find them, or we'll find another way.
You would attack the Magisters. Are you so eager to die, Seeker? You cannot stand against the Shriekers, not without stronger weapons than these.
We'll find them, or we'll find another way.
You would attack the Magisters directly. Are you so eager to die, Seeker? You cannot stand against the Shriekers, not without stronger weapons than these.
We'll find them, or we'll find another way.
You would attack the Magisters directly. Are you so eager to die, Seeker? You cannot stand against the Shriekers, not without stronger weapons than these.
We'll find them, or we'll find another way.
You would attack the Magisters directly. Are you so eager to die, Seeker? You cannot stand against the Shriekers, not without stronger weapons than these.
We'll find them, or we'll find another way.
Magisters, I'll kill everyone.
You cannot stand against the Shriekers, not without the stronger weapons than these.
find them. We'll find another way.
You would attack the magistrate. Are you so cheated?
Sending me here. It's quite beautiful, isn't it? I've prayed to Amadia real hard, but I'm not sure it's done much good. Still, a wizard trapped in a pig's body. Any ideas? Oh, what a grand idea! I'll try that. Amadia, you have heard my prayers. Well, hello. May you walk with Amadia.
Thank you. I'm a wizard, and I was a long time ago, too. In between, I was a pig, and I was on fire for most of that time. It's a long story, but I think I'll leave it in the past and look to the future. Bye now.
The others wouldn't let me join them for the fight. You should get moving, though. They'll need you at their side.
Need supplies?
Be quick about it, Little Wolf. My errands are more important than trade.
What is this place?
A tall woman stands amid a field of corpses, some fresh, some ancient. The sour smell of them stings your nostrils, your eyes. As you draw nearer, the stench blooms into a humid flavor you can almost taste. The woman turns to you, bitten lips parting into a grin. She tucks a small bunch of black-red roses into a leather strap across her left hip and, preparing to curtsy, offers you a hand.
What a ball!
She stands to her full height, her lips pursed in disappointment. She cocks her head and takes you in. The stench of death and sewage suddenly intensifies. She peers closely at you, a shrewd smile playing about her lips.
Ave de more de mea galach. Never mind. I mistook you for someone else. I am Radeka, and you must be here for the same reason as I.
She pats the bouquet at her hip.
But you're too late. These roses belong to me. Looks like we'll have to find some other way to keep you busy.
She bites her lip and leans in, close to your face. As she whispers, her breath, faintly fragrant with a sweet honeyish smell, caresses your ear. You almost forget where you are.
I find you rather delicious. Come here.
She presses her lips to yours. Her mouth is soft, her breath sweet. She kisses you gently, then harder, her teeth raking softly across your tongue. Suddenly, her breath sours in your mouth. It is rank, moldering, thick with the taint of death. You try to pull away, but she is holding you tight and hard. You hear a low hum, getting louder. Before you realize what's happening, winged insects pour from her throat down yours. They ricochet around your mouth, a wet, buzzing mass, more by the second. Suddenly, all at once, she stumbles back a few paces and wipes her mouth.
Ha ha! Tell me, little man, do you know why the soil here is so very fertile? Do you know why it's the only place in Reaper's Coast where blood roses grow? It's the corpses, darling. Blood roses only grow in soil rich with corpses. I'll need more roses soon enough. I already started with it.
Ready.
Thank you.
You see a glimmer of hope flicker across Slane's eyes as he notices your approach. It's quickly doused with a practiced scowl of the oft-disappointed.
Have you brought it? Or am I to remain a slave?
Slane rears back in eagerness, grasping the purging wand with razor-sharp claws. Before your eyes, the source from within the wand surges into his draconic form, filling him with a light so bright that you must shield your eyes from the glare. The blazing brightness dies down. Squinting, you now see no dragon before you, but the figure of a handsome lizard. A handsome lizard with the same eyes as Slane. His eyes still blaze, a piercing silver. A triumphant smile dominates his face as he bows extravagantly before you.
Slane, at your service. Neither. Both. I am a dragon knight, the last of my bloodline. Shifting between two shapes is our greatest gift. If everyone thought like you, this vile place would be little more than a sunny island. Perhaps before we are done, we can return it to such a state. Knowing such a steadfast and noble soul offers help to those in need gives me great comfort. I'd like to offer you the same. When you are truly at a loss, when you have no choice but to back down or perish, you will find safety in my shadow. This, I promise. This is an island of many mysteries, of many horrors. I'll learn what I can. Perhaps there is some possible reprieve for the souls who suffer here.
Slane smiles at you and turns to leave. He takes no more than a few steps before he shimmers out of lizard form, blurring in midair back into a majestic dragon that soars away.